This video was made in collaboration with Narutopedia. For more information, check out the link in the description. The Life of Rock Lee from Naruto. Rock Lee is a shinobi of Konohagakure's Lee clan and a member of Team Gai. Unlike most shinobi, he lacked the skills necessary to use ninjutsu or genjutsu. However, he overcomes these shortcomings by undergoing special training from Might Gai that would make him a taijutsu master while still a genin. Welcome to the Imagi. In today's video, we're going over the life of Rock Lee. Before we begin, we publish a new video every day, so be sure to subscribe to our channel and ring the bell to get notified about our latest videos. Background. During his time in the academy, Lee proved to have no talent for ninjutsu and genjutsu. When he was mocked by his peers because of this, Lee persevered, focusing on taijutsu. After he succeeded in graduating, he was added to Team Gai along with Neji Hyuga and Tenten. During the team's first meeting, Lee vowed to become a powerful ninja without using ninjutsu or genjutsu. Neji laughed at him, but their sensei, Might Gai, took a special interest in Lee. He encouraged Lee to keep at it and in time began teaching him powerful forms of taijutsu. Chunin exams. Having opted not to participate the year before, Team Gai took part in the Chunin exams along with the Rookie Nine. They initially tried to avoid attention by acting weak, but Lee accidentally let slip his true strength by interfering with a fight between Sasuke and Kotetsu Hagane. He also fell in love with Sakura. Soon afterwards, he confronted Sasuke, challenging him to a fight to see how he fared against the Sharingan, but not before knocking out Naruto, who tried to fight with Lee himself. After battling Sasuke, Lee easily gained the upper hand, but Gai interrupted Lee and Sasuke's fight as Lee tried to use the front lotus, and Lee was forced to do laps around the practice range before he could proceed into the first phase of the exams. With Tenten's help, he gained the answers for the written portion and proceeded to the second round. After spending their first few days in the Forest of Death gathering supplies, Team Gai split up in search of other teams. Lee came across Sakura being attacked by Team Dosu and went to her aid. He used his front lotus on Dosu Kanuda, but he survived the attack because of Zaku Abumi using his decapitating airwaves in the ground, and Lee was left unable to defend himself from a counterattack from Dosu. Neji and Tenten soon arrived to help, but didn't have to because Sasuke woke up and took care of Team Dosu. Once Lee recovered and they collected the specific scroll, they moved on to the preliminaries. In the preliminaries, Lee was matched against Gaara. When his standard attacks proved unable to bypass Gaara's defenses, he removed his ankle weights to increase his speed and managed to land a couple of hits on Gaara. Then he attempted the forward lotus, but Gaara was able to escape at the last minute, revealing a sand clone instead. His options running out if he was to win and prove himself, Gai allowed him to use the reverse lotus. Gaara barely survived by turning his gourd to sand to cushion him, but the techniques took a massive toll on Lee's body. Gaara added to Lee's injury by crushing his left arm and leg. Though Gai intervened to stop Gaara from killing him, Lee got to his feet to continue the battle, despite being completely unconscious. Because of his injuries, medics predicted that even if Lee recovered, his injuries would prevent him from ever being able to be a shinobi again. He nevertheless tried to train while he was in the hospital, something that only worsened his condition. When he was asleep, Gaara came into his room and tried to kill him, but he was stopped by Naruto and Shikamaru Nara and later by Gai. To try and cheer Lee up, Gai took him to watch the final round matches, but they were surprised when they arrived to find out that Neji had been defeated by Naruto. Lee silently congratulated Naruto and then watched Gaara's fight with Sasuke and marveled at how quickly he had learned to emulate Lee's speed. Before the fight could finish, however, the Konoha Crush began and Lee was knocked unconscious. Konoha Crush. Lee can be seen at the third Hokage's funeral alongside the other villagers mourning his death. Sasuke Recovery Mission. Over the coming weeks, Gai tried a number of his own remedies to heal Lee, though none of his efforts worked. It was not until news of Tsunade becoming Hokage reached them that they found hope. But when she examined Lee, she informed him of the dire situation. His broken bones and torn muscles have healed, but fragments of bone had lodged in his spinal column, and removing them would involve an extensive operation that only she was capable of. When Tsunade offered him an operation that carried a 50% chance of returning him to his former state or dying in the process, Lee was hesitant to accept the operation. Though Lee was worried he would die in the operation, thanks to Gai's influence, he accepted the surgery. Upon overhearing Naruto, Choji Akamichi, Kiba Inuzuka, and Shikamaru talking about the mission to bring Sasuke back to Konoha, Lee suggested that Neji go with them. Lee was disappointed that he couldn't go with them, still needing to go through with his surgery that was scheduled for later that day. In the anime, Lee was recovering after having his surgery done the day before. In the end, Lee successfully survived the operation. Once Lee was well enough to move, he left the hospital to follow them and provide assistance. He caught up with Naruto, who was in the middle of a battle with Kimimaro, and told him to go after Sasuke while he dealt with Kimimaro. At first, it seemed Kimimaro outmatched him, but after Lee drank some sake that had been mistaken for medicine, he began to outclass Kimimaro. Though Lee's anticipated moves were unpredictable to Kimimaro, he revealed his Keke Genkai, Shiko Tsumyaku, which combined with Lee's sobering up easily took over the battle. Before his attack landed on Lee, Gaara arrived just in time to save him. Even though Lee insisted to fight side by side with him, he knew he was only getting in Gaara's way. For the rest of the battle, Lee watches and is amazed by Gaara's new abilities. Even though Gaara's new techniques completely buried Kimimaro, Kimimaro counters by turning the battlefield into a forest of bones, which Lee and Gaara escape by hanging onto a pair of small clouds made out of sand. Kimimaro then emerged from one of the bones, preparing to kill the two at point-blank range. They were saved, however, as Kimimaro finally succumbed to his disease and died. After their battle, Lee and Gaara reflect upon Kimimaro's purpose, and the two return to Konoha. Kurosuki Family Removal Mission. In the anime, Lee revealed that he once ran a marathon with Guy near the village of Katabami Kinzan shortly after being assigned to his team, and when he collapsed from exhaustion near the Curry of Life shop, the owner, Sancho, and her son Karashi fed him curry and saved his life. Lee's dedication caused Karashi to become enthusiastic, and he later left. A year later, when he came to the village with his teammates and Naruto to defeat the Kurosuki family, he found that Karashi had joined, and was upset that Karashi had sought strength this way. He allowed Karashi to seek redemption, but Karashi used this opportunity to lure Lee's group into a trap after their first battle with Raiga. The trap failed due to Naruto's use of shadow clones, and while the villagers were willing to seek vengeance on Karashi, Lee stepped in, promising to take responsibility for his actions. Karashi used the opportunity to take Ranmaru to revive Raiga. Lee went to fight Raiga with Naruto and Neji, and was knocked out, but brought back to consciousness with the Curry of Life. The curry, however, accidentally contained wine, and Lee was intoxicated and performed the Drunken Fist. He fought Raiga drunkenly, but was defeated, and Naruto finished Raiga off. Later, when the group went back to the Curry of Life shop, they found out that Karashi had made a new curry that looked so bad that even Naruto didn't want to eat it. Lee, however, couldn't wait to try it, so the rest of the group had to literally drag him back to Konoha while he cried for the curry. Academy student-led mission. In the anime, Lee was assigned to lead a team of 3 academy students on a survival exercise. After fending off some bandits, one of Lee's charges addressed Lee as Lee Sensei out of awe, and overjoyed, Lee went off into one of his declarations into the sunset whilst his students tried to tell him that he was going the wrong way. The appearance of strange visitors. In the anime, Guy and Lee left the village on a mission, and 2 spies tried to imitate them. Tsunade immediately saw through their disguise and gave them various difficult, disgusting, or humiliating missions in order to keep them busy and prevent them from learning anything. Lee and Guy spot the imposters leaving the village. The imposters attacked, but were sent flying back to Konoha. Star Guard Mission. In the anime, Lee accompanied Neji, Naruto, and Tenten on the mission to Hoshigakure, playing a lesser role than in previous arcs. He attempted to follow 2 of Akahoshi's men when hiding under a barrel, as Tenten suggested, but was discovered almost instantly. While trying to infiltrate Akahoshi's mansion, he pretended to use a jutsu known as wall-removing technique, but in actuality, it involved him moving at a high speed to open a door from another side. He was wounded during the final battle with Akahoshi, leaving Naruto to fight him alone. Viva Dojo Challenge! Youth is all about passion. In the anime, Lee, seeing that he had little time to train with other people during the many missions that must be done, sought new means of training. After having seen a man challenging a dojo, ready to take the sign if he won, and ready to join if he lost, Lee founds his own dojo, which he names the Guts Dojo, believing that a dojo would draw in many strong opponents. When Naruto stumbled upon the dojo, Lee asked that he fight, but Naruto had to leave hastily, late for reporting back to Tsunade. Guy, after hearing about the dojo from Naruto, decides to disguise himself in order to fight Lee. However, he was given a mission at the last second and, unbeknownst to Guy, an imposter replaced him. Lee fought the imposter and easily defeated him, but Naruto believed that the imposter was Guy and that he was not fighting at full strength in order to avoid revealing himself. So Naruto challenges and fights against Lee. Meanwhile, the imposter transformed into Lee, but met the real Guy while trying to leave and was easily defeated by him. Third Great Beast Arc. In the anime, Lee's condition worsened and Tsunade became concerned about him injuring himself again. She removed him from missions, but allowed him to keep training after he convinced her to do so. Around this time, Guy arrived with a new student who easily defeated Lee and injured his ankle. While Lee was recovering, Guy took the new student with him on a mission, causing Lee to believe that he had abandoned him. It was then revealed that the new student was an imposter and that he planned on seeking vengeance against Guy. Lee headed to Guy's location, but was trapped in a castle made out of sparring posts. He and Lee were tricked into fighting each other by seeing the other as a sparring dummy, but they saw through the technique, recognizing each other's fighting style, and opened their chakra gates to destroy the dummies without harming the actual person, freeing themselves and destroying the castle. Konoha plans recapture mission. In the anime, Lee and the rest of the Konoha 11 came down together to stop Genno from bombing Konoha. Despite having few special abilities, he made some noteworthy contributions to the investigation. While he initially encouraged the Academy students to keep practicing throwing kunai, once he realized that hitting the bullseye would cause a chain reaction that would detonate explosives around Konoha, he caught a kunai in midair just before it hit the target, despite being far away from it. Lee defeated Genno with his taijutsu during the final confrontation. Gantetsu Escort Mission. In the anime, Naruto accompanied Sakura and Lee to escort Gantetsu. When the ship was sliced in half by a metal wire, Lee ended up with Sakura and found the orphans Gantetsu had cared for. During the raid on the hideout, he found the Shinobazu members outside. Tsunagakure Support Mission. In the anime, Lee and Naruto helped Gaara fight and defeat Seimei, an opponent who could absorb his enemy's chakra with his armor. After the mission, he sparred with Tenten, who was upset over being the only member of the Konoha 11 left out of the mission despite having a mission at the time, and noted that, in order to be able to face Naruto when he returned, they too must become stronger. In Naruto's Footsteps, the Friend's Paths. In the anime, after about 2 years, the Chunin exams are held, co-sponsored by Konoha and Suna. While waiting to register, Team Guy spots Naruto, much to their surprise. However, Neji reveals that it was only Konohamaru in disguise, who explained that he didn't want Naruto to miss out on this opportunity since he was away. With some comforting words from Lee and Neji, Konohamaru and his friends take their leave. As a part of the first stage, all teams were randomly split into different rooms to take a written test. Lee was placed into room 2 with Ino Yamanaka and Shino Aburame. On a monitor, Shikamaru, as proctor, explained that everyone only needed to answer one question, but their team's combined score must equal exactly 100 points to pass. Thanks to Neji, all the teams that were struggling were able to figure out which question to answer based on the specific amount of vibrations sent through the wall. To everyone's surprise, Shikamaru revealed a bonus question which asked that if a situation required you to sacrifice a teammate to be a decoy, which one would you choose? This, however, was a trick question that required no answer as it was a test of loyalty, something that Lee and his team understood, allowing them to pass the first stage. However, as a result of having too many participants, a race to Suna was held, where only the first 30 teams to arrive at the destination would qualify for the second stage. Ultimately, his team was among the first 30 teams to make it. During dinner, the Genin tried to help Borami from leaking sweat all over the food, and although they were able to successfully do that, the food was still ruined as a result of Neji's 8 trigrams palms revolving heaven accidentally knocking the food down. This caused an all-out brawl between the Genin and the room. Lee tried not to fight, but when he tried to strike Shira, his attack proved futile. Eventually, everyone lost their desire to fight when Fu arrived with her optimistic ways. Later, Lee approached Shira, noting from their earlier encounter that he also endured much adversity, to which Shira stated true determination will ultimately succeed. The following day, the second exam began. Like the last exam in Konoha, the teams were given either a heaven or earth scroll, and were required to obtain the other scroll. They would then have to bring the set to the main building in the center of the Demon Desert, having 3 days to do so. As they began wandering around aimlessly, Lee realized a pattern and began marking rocks with kunai, concluding that they were wandering in circles. After dispelling the genjutsu, they find Team Goji and proceed to attack them, only for Team Shira to interfere and help their fellow Suna Nin. Unbeknownst to Team Guy, they get caught in another genjutsu by Sen. After Sen undoes the genjutsu, Team Guy finds that they are caught in quicksand, which drags them down to a waterfall sand pit. Lee manages to save his teammates and himself from falling to their doom after opening the second of the 8 gates. After escaping from the pit, they find Team Shira in trouble, as they were being attacked by treacherous Suna Nin. Feeling compelled to help, Team Guy decides to come to Team Shira's aid, after which Neji asked why they were attacked at all. It was explained that Team Goji simply had no respect for Shira as a ninja, with Lee deducing that, like him, Shira had no skill for genjutsu and ninjutsu, causing him to be ridiculed by his peers. Lee, in a fit of rage over Team Goji's disrespect, storms off to convince them to apologize to Shira. When this fails, the Suna Nin attack, trapping Lee in a sandstorm that cast illusions of figures attacking to distract him from the real threat when they strike him with water needles. Just as he's about to be finished, Neji and Tenten arrive to save him. Before the battle continues, Shira begs the Konoha Nin not to leave them be, insisting that their distaste of him is his own fault for not training hard enough. Lee believed the very opposite, however, but ultimately he and his team agreed. Shira offered his scroll to one of the Suna Nin teams, as they technically defeated his team earlier. As Shira's words finally reached the spiteful Suna Nin, they declined and instead gave Shira's team and Lee's team their own respective scrolls as they lost this battle. After the Suna Nin left, determined like Shira to prove themselves by finding more scrolls, Shira agreed to Lee's request to do a one-on-one battle. While seemingly equal in raw power and skill, Neji noted that Shira had a slight advantage with his more solid build, and by extension, greater raw strength. As Lee attempted to use the 8 gates, he was unable to do so due to Shira already anticipating this and striking his pressure points beforehand. As Lee began changing tactics from Might Guy's teachings, manipulating how Shira would move, he began to drive Shira back. After acknowledging each other's determination, Shira struck Lee's pressure points again to remove the block, wanting to face Lee at his best. As Lee entered the 8 gates, Shira used the 7 heavens breathing method, which proved to be on par with the 8 gates. As the intensity grew between the two, Shira's previously wounds began to reopen, prompting Lee to call off the fight. As Shira was being healed by Yomei, he explained that after the Chunin exams ends, he will be enlisting in a special force on the outskirts of Suna so that he could be closer to his parents. Lee wished Shira good luck and gave him one of his jumpsuits as a gift, acknowledging their new friendship. On the third day of the exam, Team Guy crossed paths with a team of Ame Kunoichi and battles them. After a short skirmish, the enemy team decides to retreat as Team Guy was not the target they sought. Despite this, Lee's team pursued the Ame Nin into old ruins. Despite their continued battle, the ground collapsed, swallowing Tenten and Ajisai, separating them from their respective teams. Though Lee and Neji wanted to work together to save one another's teammate, the two Ame Nin turned them down and left. Lee suggested that they plow their way through the rubble, only for Neji to reject the idea for fear of causing more damage than desired. When Lee and Neji find the two Ame Nin, they aid them in their fight against another Konoha team, as they needed their help to find Tenten. This prompted the other Konoha team to retreat as they were outnumbered. After the two teams agree to work together, they battle a colony of large ants, but it is Tenten who defeats them. Having now been reunited, the two teams part ways peacefully. Later, Team Guy gets caught in a massive sandstorm. Unable to push forward, Neji repelled the sand long enough for Tenten to summon a protective dome for them to wait out the storm. After the storm cleared, and they resumed their efforts to pass the exam, they spotted Matsuri, who begged them to help save Gaara. Team Guy was soon approached by Fu's teammates, who agreed to unite their efforts in hopes of saving Fu and Gaara. While Lee and Matsuri joined Fu's teammates in distracting Hoichi, Neji and Tenten tried to save the Jinchuriki. Ultimately, Neji was able to free Gaara and Fu with his gentle fist, which came at Hoichi's expense as the chains soon turned on him, while seeking Tailed Beast Chakra and ultimately bound him. Despite lacking a matching set of scrolls, Lee's team decided to complete the exams and head to the main building. There, it was learned that the Chunin exams were ended early due to controversy happening in the second exam. Instead, it was decided by Gaara that a report on each participant would be sent to their respective village leader for them to decide if they would be promoted. Upon returning to the village, Tsunade promoted Lee and Tenten to Chunin, while Neji was promoted to Jonin. Kazekage Rescue Mission. After Team Kakashi was sent on a mission to rescue Gaara from Akatsuki, Tsunade began to worry that they might have problems, so she sent Team Guy as backup. On their way to a rendezvous point, they encountered Pakun, who redirected them to Team Kakashi's destination. Soon after, they were attacked by Kisame Hoshigaki. As the battle waged on, Lee was able to disarm Kisame shortly, but was soon captured alongside Neji and Tenten in a water prison by Kisame's water clones. After a while, Neji was able to free Lee and himself, allowing Lee to rescue Tenten before she suffocated. Afterwards, they watched on as Guy finished off Kisame. Upon Kisame's defeat, they discovered that it was not really him they were fighting. It was only a lookalike. Realizing they were being stalled, Pakun led them on towards Team 7. When they convened with Team Kakashi, Team Guy was tasked with bringing down the barrier blocking the entrance to the Akatsuki lair. Neji used his Byakugan to find the seals keeping the barrier in place and directed the locations of them to the rest of the team. Once they found the seals, they simultaneously took them off, succeeding in removing the barrier, but in the process were immediately ambushed by copies of themselves. Soon after, Lee and his clones started fighting, matching each other attack for attack. After being evenly matched with his clone, Lee communicated to the rest of the team who were in the same situation and proposed a solution: to become stronger than they had been when the copies had been created. With that, Lee used a new technique and defeated his clone. With their battles won, Team Guy reunited and went to meet up with Team 7 again. On their way, Neji spotted Deidara with his Byakugan, and the team managed to sneak behind him in time to block his escape. After fighting Team Guy, Deidara realized he was outmatched and attempted a retreat. While on Deidara's tail, Team Guy cornered him, leading him to make an exploding clone, resulting in almost killing both teams were it not for Kakashi's intervention. After Gaara was revived and their mission completed, both teams accompanied him back to Tsunagakure, and later paid their respects at Chiyo's grave. Afterwards, both teams departed for Konoha. On their way, Guy started carrying Kakashi, who had been incapacitated from using the Mangekyo Sharingan too much. Seeing this as a form of training, Lee told Neji to get on his back so they might race back to Konoha, but was forcefully rejected. Tenchi Bridge Reconnaissance Mission. Lee and the rest of Team Guy were only seen in the very beginning of this arc in the anime, as they returned from Suna. Lee, thinking he had come in second place in he and Gai's race from Tsunagakure to Konoha, was shocked when Gai informed him that since he was carrying Kakashi on his back as well, Lee had only come in third. 12. Guardian Ninja. In the anime, Lee and his peers were invited by Asuma Sarutobi to join him for a lunch out with a guest from outside the village. When the village was invaded by Furido's four-man team, the enemies resurrected members of the Kohaku clan. Lee fought alongside other Konoha nin to keep the zombie nin at bay. Later, when Sora, who was discovered to be a pseudo-Jinchuriki, transformed, he and the others went to stop him. However, Sora proved too much and Naruto instead faced him and eventually stopped him. At the end, the invaders were all defeated. Akatsuki Suppression Mission. In the anime, he is seen at Asuma's funeral, mourning his loss. Three Tails Appearance. In the anime, Lee was placed on Team 2 with Yamato as a leader and assistance from Tenten, Kiba, and Akamaru. After his team settles in their position, they spot an enemy. Lee storms in for an attack, connecting with a kick, but the enemy is revealed to be a smoke clone. The real Kagiri and his allies reveal themselves, and soon Lee finds himself trapped in a smoke screen. After remembering a discussion about using other senses with Gai, he found his way through and attacked Kiho with Front Lotus. His team ultimately defeated the opposing shinobi. Later, he battled alongside Tenten against Guren and Rinji on the lake, while Team 3 tried to seal the Three Tails. After the beast went berserk, he and the others retreated, carrying an unconscious Ino to shore. After recuperating, they all agreed to try the task again. Afterwards, Lee and his team end up battling the enemies from earlier. Unfortunately, his team lost due to the enemy's cursed seals being activated, making them stronger than before. Later, to his and the others' surprise, the enemies merged, becoming an even bigger threat. However, the Three Tails, while on its rampage, crushed the merged foes. Having failed to seal the beast the second time, they returned to Konoha. Pain's Assault. During Pain's assault on Konoha, Team Gai was away on a mission. On their way returning to the village, they noticed a large number of birds flying from the direction of the village and rushed to see what the issue was. The team then stumbled upon a defeated Gamabunta, who informed them that the village was being destroyed. When they arrived to see the village in ruins, they also spotted a severely wounded Hinata Hyuga, and got her medical attention after Tenten noted that her wounds weren't fatal. Katsuyu later informed them that Naruto was fighting with the last Pain member, much to everyone's shock. Gai insisted that he and his team provide backup, but Katsuyu mentions that Naruto does not want anyone else to get involved. Later, Lee, alongside the other villagers, celebrated Naruto's victory over Pain. 5. Kage Summit. When news reaches Konoha of Sasuke Uchiha's crimes against other villages, Lee and the rest of the Konoha 11 decide they should eliminate Sasuke themselves before he can involve Konoha in a war. So that Sakura can inform Naruto of their decision, Lee, Kiba, and Sai escort her to the Land of Iron. When they locate him, Sakura tells Naruto that she loves him, surprising Lee. This does not convince him to give up in his own search for Sasuke, so they leave without another word, despite Lee's protest. Sakura then asks her escorts to help her find Sasuke. When they near his location, while Lee, along with Kiba, try to protest how telling Naruto the truth would have been better, Sakura tries to knock them out so she can face Sasuke alone. Sai stops her, so Sakura convinces Lee and Kiba that he's a traitor. While they try and detain him, she succeeds in knocking them out. After Sakura and the rest of Team 7 meet with Sasuke, they retrieve Lee and the others and return to Konoha. Lee is later seen with the rest of the Konoha 11, hearing Naruto's decision to take responsibility for Sasuke. Though they protest this action, Naruto firmly states that he would be the one to take care of Sasuke. Before leaving, he promises to tell them everything when the time was right. Power. In the anime, Lee and his teammates were sent to back up Team Kakashi, who were investigating what was happening at the hole located in the Tonika village. During this mission, Lee and Gai confronted Naruto's berserk clone, and after opening the fifth gate alongside his mentor, was able to stave off the creature before it took on a pseudo Nine Tails form. 4th Shinobi World War, Confrontation. During the 4th Shinobi World War, Lee is assigned to the 3rd Division alongside Sakura and Gai. He is seen fretting over his sensei's condition while Sakura tries to heal him. When members of the Surprise Attack Division are attacked by the reincarnated shinobi, the 3rd Division arrives in time to intercept the attack. He is then seen along with the 3rd Division clashing against the reincarnated ninja. Upon Kakashi's orders, they group into a Manji formation. Lee promises that no matter what, he will protect Sakura. She, however, tells him also to be careful, as last time Zabuza was able to penetrate the formation from its weak point, the center. He and Gai later intercepted Haku's assault with the leaf-coiling whirlwind. In the anime, after the 7 ninja swordsmen of the mist were summoned, Gai told Lee to chase after Pakura while he went after Gari. After a long day battling, Lee recuperates with his remaining division members as night falls. When the battle resumes the next day, Lee sticks close to Sai, who has been tasked with sealing the reincarnated seven ninja swordsmen of the mist. Lee tells Sai not to worry and just concentrate on the sealing while he would protect him. When Naruto's shadow clone arrives on the battlefield, Lee exclaims that with him there, their numbers would increase. However, Naruto tells them that he wouldn't be able to perform the shadow clone technique in his current state, so they'd have to defeat the new wave of White Zetsu army clones with quality of techniques instead of quantity in numbers. Later, in the anime, the 3rd Division came across another reincarnated shinobi, Master Chen, a renowned hero of Konohagakure who was thought to have died during the 3rd Shinobi World War. As might Guy, who was happy at the prospect of challenging such a famed taijutsu master, Konoha's sublime green beast of prey soon finds himself being forced on the defensive by the old man. A shinobi is able to break away from battle and in his search for reinforcements finds Rock Lee, who rushes to Guy's aid. Seeing the legend he once met before as a genin before him, Lee reveals his history with Chen before engaging the legend in battle. Ultimately, Lee is able to counter Chen's leaf dragon god technique using a one-man front lotus, which he had engineered to counter the rotation of the winds of the former. As Chen's immortal body disintegrates, he remembers the time when he had his own student who was incapable of using ninjutsu, and how he had died during the 3rd Shinobi World War. Finally letting go of his painful past and apologizing to the young man for what he had said, the old master was able to break the summoning contract and his soul returns to the afterlife. Lee promises to Chen that he'll bring rice balls to his grave. 4th Shinobi World War, Climax. After being informed by Inoichi from HQ that Naruto and Bee were fighting the masked Madara, Lee and the rest of the Konoha 11 rush to his aid. Upon finally arriving at the battlefield and seeing his mentor's state, Lee asks whether or not Guy had used the daytime tiger technique again. He later stood with the other members of the allied shinobi forces as they prepared to face their opposition. Opening the fifth gate, Lee and his mentor prepare to attack the two Uchiha, but are buffeted by the force exerted by the now fully matured Ten-Tails as it escapes the hole it had seemingly been trapped in. He is then seen with Guy and Ten-Ten reacting to Neji's death. Tearfully holding his fallen comrade's corpse, he was stopped by Guy, who told him to keep his tears and hold on to the feelings Neji left them. Lee was then seen listening on as Naruto imparted comforting words to the allied forces. Thinking back on his time with Neji growing up and the conversations they had, Lee mused about something Neji had said to him. Having received chakra from Naruto, the now empowered Lee respectfully closed his fallen comrade's eyes before joining the ranks of the other allied shinobi. Charging forward with the alliance, Lee signaled to Naruto that he would deal with Madara while he took care of Obito. With Guy giving him a boost, Lee propelled towards Madara and remorselessly bisected the Uchiha with a powerful kick, also destroying Madara's connection to the beast. Birth of the Ten-Tails Jinchuriki. Lee would later stare in amazement at the red barrier that had been constructed around the Ten-Tails, and listened on as Guy noted that only shinobi of Hokage caliber were able to perform the four red yang formation technique. With the situation later turning grim as the alliance was trapped in a barrier with a tailed beast ball firing tree, Lee and the other shinobi soon found themselves shrouded in the previous version 1 mantles again. He and the others subsequently found themselves on the outside of the barrier, escaping the near-fatal attack thanks to Naruto and Minato's action. The Ten-Tails transformed into its tree form, and many shinobi were attacked, but Lee was able to escape. Hashirama Senju had Ino Yamanaka link up everyone telepathically, Lee being one of them. Hashirama's words fail to inspire anyone, but Naruto's Senjutsu enhanced tailed beast mode combined with Ino's telepathy causes his emotions and personal memories to be transferred to everyone. Later, he mobilized alongside his comrades when Naruto called out to them. Shocked when he was enveloped by Naruto's tailed beast mode mantle, Lee was apprehensive about their strategy at first, but ultimately launched an attack on Obito and was able to overwhelm his defense, giving Naruto and Sasuke the opportunity to attack Obito directly. He and his comrades later aided Naruto in extracting the tailed beast's chakra from Obito in order to stop the holy tree from blooming. After his sensei overexerted himself, unable to stand up on his own, Lee resorted to supporting him. While doing so, Lee and his teammates noticed Gaara speeding past them, where Lee noticed Sakura was with him. As Guy begins to worry about the situation, Madara, having just revived himself and become the Ten-Tailed Jinchuriki himself, flies past the Konoha Nin and regurgitates the Benihisago and Kohaku no Johei, which landed on top of both Guy and Lee. After recomposing themselves, Guy and Lee went on ahead while Ten-Ten remained behind. Guy arrived on the battlefield in time to save Kakashi and then confront Madara. Lee arrived shortly after in time to save his teacher from Madara's attack. As Guy reassessed the situation, he decided to gamble his life and use the 8th gate against Madara. Lee began to cry at the realization of what Guy's actions would mean. Guy, however, told Lee not to be sad as this was his choice. Lee watched on proudly as Guy reached full power taking on Madara. When the team decided to support Guy so that he could land an attack on the Uchiha, Lee immediately opened the sixth gate, but was angered by his own ability to fight at the same level to help Guy. Minato told Lee not to feel that way as Guy was making his sacrifice so Lee could live. After Minato explained the mechanics of Madara's truth-seeking balls, Lee threw the fourth Hokage's flying thunder god kunai in front of the chakra orbs, which allowed Minato to teleport most of the orbs away. Ultimately, the team gave Guy the opening to land the five powerful blows from his evening elephant. Lee watched on in amazement as his mentor unleashed another powerful attack on Madara, noting that this time the stance he took was not that of the evening elephant, but the night Guy technique. Lee was later shocked to see Naruto return with Guy, who was still alive despite opening all of the eight gates. When Madara attempted to drop the massive earthen debris on the ground, Gaara asked him to leave there quickly, but later they fell victim to the infinite Tsukuyomi. Inside the Genjutsu, Lee dreamed of finally defeating both Naruto and Neji in battle, followed quickly by Sakura professing her love for him. Kaguya Otsutsuki strikes. Ultimately, Lee and the rest of the world were freed from the Genjutsu by Naruto and Sasuke, who ended the war. Kakashi Hiden, lightning in the icy sky. Lee helps Guy sneak aboard the Tobishachimaru so he can fulfill his lifelong dream of flying. When Kakashi spots Lee, covered in a cloak, disembarking from the ship, he confronts him. Once he realizes that it's Lee and figures out what he's done, Kakashi also sneaks on board to join Guy. Lee later informs the 5th Hokage that Kakashi and Guy are aboard the Tobishachimaru, which has since been hijacked. The last, Naruto the movie. During Toneri's attack on Earth, Lee and other Taijutsu users defend Konoha from a larger meteorite after he opened the sixth gate. Konoha Hiden, the perfect day for a wedding. When Lee is assigned to bring a present to Naruto and Hinata's wedding, he takes the mission as seriously as he takes all his missions. Very. He runs laps around Konoha until he can think of what to buy for them. 864 laps later, Lee collapses from exhaustion. The best idea he came up with was a pair of dumbbells, which he doesn't think would be appropriate. While passed out from fatigue, Lee has a dream of Neji. Neji starts giving him advice for the wedding present, but only manages to make unclear references to strength and stamina before Lee wakes up. As Lee lies in the middle of the street, he's greeted by Guy. Guy is also about to do laps around Konoha until he can think about what to buy for Naruto and Hinata and invites Lee to join him. Lee reports that he's already done this without success. Guy suggests that Lee try coming up with a gift for Hinata instead while he thinks of a gift for Naruto. Lee thinks about Hinata's post-wedding life of childcare and housework. Guy thinks of Naruto's post-wedding life of home maintenance and carrying groceries. Both simultaneously conclude that they should buy dumbbells to prepare Naruto and Hinata for their lives ahead. Neji's words suddenly make sense to Lee as he embraces Guy in a long, tearful hug. In order to test out their idea, Lee puts on a dress and makeup so he can see what it's like to be a housewife. This only convinces him that dumbbells were a great idea, so he seeks out Tenten to make sure she won't be getting Naruto and Hinata the same present. At the wedding a few days later, she gives Lee and Guy advice about how they should behave. New Era. In the following years, Lee was promoted to Jonin. He also has a son named Metal Lee, whom he trained with. Academy Entrance Arc. When Metal was helping his classmate, Denki Kaminarimon, train to prepare for a chakra climbing test, Lee saved Denki from injuring himself by catching the falling student. Deeply touched by Denki's drive to succeed, Lee decided to supervise Denki's continued training. By the end of the day, he gave Denki a jumpsuit, insisting it would help him with his training. Sarada Uchiha Arc. During the days of the Kage Summit in Konoha, Rock was rigorously training with his son, as Rock emphatically told him that he was in the springtime of his youth. Naruto Shinden, Parent and Child Day. When Konohagakure began a new annual holiday, Parent and Child Day, Lee spent it with his son. He was also accompanied by Sai, Shikamaru, and their respective sons. Later, he and Metal entered an eating competition as a team. However, Metal's anxiety at being watched quickly made him vomit, disqualifying the team. After Metal recovered, he and his father spent the remainder of the day training together. Graduation Exams Arc. As ninja classes began preparing for the graduation exams, Lee met with Metal and his teachers to discuss his son's progress and goals for the future, during which Lee and his son continued their over-enthusiastic training routine. Versus Momoshiki Arc. Rock Lee serves as the proctor for the third and final round of the Chunin exams. During the seventh match between Boruto Uzumaki and Shikadai Nara, Boruto seemingly wins, but Naruto discovers that Boruto used a Kote to cheat. Lee disqualified Boruto for using this prohibited tool and declares Shikadai the winner. Soon after, Momoshiki and Kinshiki attack the arena. In the anime, as Lee began training his son in more advanced taijutsu, ready to teach the Eight Gates, he learned that Metal began relying on useless good luck trinkets for confidence against his anxiety from too much attention. Disappointed by this, Lee postponed the training, telling Metal that he couldn't master the Eight Gates as he was then. Later, after Metal spent the day with Guy and learned about making the most of what you have, Lee decided to issue a challenge to Metal. To receive training in the Eight Gates, Metal was to face Lee in a match surrounded by a huge crowd and must land at least one blow. Accepting the challenge, Metal removed his trinkets and fought through all the stares and laughter of the crowd, which in reality boosted his performance. Ultimately, Metal unlocked the first gate, letting him solidly hit his father and win. Lee joined Metal and Guy in a group hug to celebrate Metal's success. Time slip. In the anime, when the grown-up Sasuke and Boruto were sent back in time shortly after Sasuke's defection, the two pretended to be traveling performers and were put under watch by Naruto. Past Lee and his friends helped Boruto and Naruto clean up a bathhouse after the commotion Naruto and Jiraiya caused. Kara Actuation. When learning of Kara, Konohagakure sent Rock Lee to inform Kirigakure about it. Did you enjoy our video? Make sure to check out these other great videos from the Amagi, and make sure to subscribe and ring the bell to be notified about our latest videos.